Hi everybody, my name is Carlos Roberto Chirinos. It's great to be with you. Remember to stay safe by staying at home, washing your hands properly, wearing a face mask correctly, and respecting the social distancing. Today's lesson we are going to talk about adverbs of place. Let's get started. Pay attention, please. Class, I'm going to show you some of my items in my living room and how they are organized. Les presentaré una muestra de cómo están organizados los artículos en la sala de mi casa. Pay attention. This is my living room. I own many things to stay there. I have a sofa in. As you can see, there is a book on it. I have also some pillows next to, my sneakers under, and the carpet below. I have two chairs in the wall. The blue is next to the yellow. They are up. And the white is far. It is down. Now, could you tell me where the items are located in your room? ¿Dónde están ubicadas las de su habitación? Great! Let's learn some adverbs of place. Up, down. Let's continue. In, out, far, next to, indoors, outdoors. The followings are under, on, upstairs, downstairs, near, away, below, above, under, over. In the following conversation, Rob is a secretary that needs a friend's office to do an extra work. Class, pay attention to the conversation between Rob and his friend. Don't repeat. Hi John, I need your office. Sure, you can go after work. Is there a computer in? Oh yes, I keep a laptop on my desk. You can also find food outside. Thanks. Now, repeat the conversation after me. Comencemos. Hi, John. I need your office. Sure. You can go after work. Is there a computer in? Oh yes. I keep a laptop on my desk. You can also find food outside. Thanks. There you go. This time you are going to be John. Comencemos. Hi John, I need your office. Is there a computer in? Thanks. You did it great. As you heard in the previous conversation, the adverbs of place talk about locations and movements. Now, we are going to practice in the following exercises. Get ready. Okay, class, look at the picture. Then, select the correct adverb to complete the statement. Seleccionen el adverbio apropiado para completar las oraciones. Let's start. Very good. Number one is she jumps up. Let's continue. Excellent. The statement should be please sit down. Number three. Nice job. The answer is the letter C. Come in. Now, according to this picture and a previous description of my living room, say if the statements are true or false. De acuerdo a esta imagen y la descripción anterior, digan si los enunciados son verdaderos o falsos. Number one. There is a sofa in. Very good. It is true. Number two. Two chairs are down. Great, it is false. There is a carpet below. Yes, it is true. Preposition seems to be the same as adverbs of place. Both talk about movements and locations. But what makes them different is that preposition needs a noun phrase, while the adverb doesn't. Take a look at the examples. In the sentence, she looks down the roster and he went in the house, the word down and in function as preposition. It is because of the noun phrase, the roster and the house. On the other hand, in the statement, please sit down and he went in, the word down and in function as adverbs. Sigamos practicando y aprendiendo, cause a different language is a different vision of life.